Another important attribute of lenses is whether it's a zoom lens or not. A lot of new cinematographers prefer zoom lenses because they allow you to adjust the focal length without changing lenses. So it feels like getting several lenses in one. And while zoom lenses are very convenient, there are also several reasons to use lenses that only have one focal length. Lenses that don't have zoom features are referred to as prime lenses. You know, zoom lenses are kind of a miracle of modern science. There's a lot going on in there. So prime lenses tend to be a lot lighter, which can be better for handheld shots. But more importantly, prime lenses tend to have significantly better image quality. Finally, prime lenses also tend to be much faster than zoom lenses. And when we call lenses fast, we basically are saying that their apertures can open wide and let in a lot of light. So this means that prime lenses typically have apertures that open up much more than zoom lenses. This makes prime lenses a better choice for achieving a shallow depth of field in many cases. As we'll talk about later in this course, remember that you don't have to buy everything that you use. I rented two prime lenses for the assurance, a Canon 14mm and a Canon 24mm. They really came in handy for this shoot, but I don't know that they're worth purchasing for me right now. So even if high quality lenses are out of your budget, or if you just want to experiment with the different types of lenses to see which ones work best, remember that you can always rent them. Prime lenses are usually lighter, faster, cheaper, and have better image quality than zoom lenses. Some directors will only use prime lenses because of their superior optical qualities. So just remember that the ability to zoom on a lens is not always the most important attribute. Next, we'll wrap up this chapter by looking at creating a rack focus effect.